Dear friends, in this class, we will see how to subnet a network. What do you mean by subnetting? Before I proceed, for the reference purpose, for the explanation purpose, I use Todd Lamblay CCNA book. I use CCNA Todd Lamblay PDF for the explanation purpose. So you can see subnetting means dividing major network into smaller network. What is the use of that one? By using that one, by means of that one, I can save the IP address. For example, you think something like this. I have around 2000 computers. I need 2000 address. I cannot use class C because class C's capability is 254. Class C network capability is 254 host. It can address 254 host. So I cannot use class C. So what is the alternative way? Alternative way is I can use class B. Class B, if you use, my requirement is 2000 and class B can address around 65,000 host. So how many addresses I am going to waste? Around 63,000 address I am going to waste. So what we do is we will divide this class B network into smaller area net, smaller blocks, and we will allocate blocks to particular organization. So in that case, the wastage will be less compared to this one. So that is the main basics of subnetting. Subnetting means dividing major network into smaller network, and it is also helps for easier administration. So that is the use. So now, before move to subnetting, so here you have to see subnet mask. Before I explain subnet mask, we need to understand what is the default mask. So in my previous class, I told you class A means 8 bits are allocated for network and 24 bits are allocated for host. Class B is 16 bits are allocated for network, 16 bits are allocated for host. Class C is 24 bits are allocated for network and 8 bits are allocated. But you have to convey this to the computer. How to convey this one? For that one, I am using one default mask. So in the default mask, 255.0.0.0. 255 means all ones. All ones, it indicates network portion. Here also, 255, all ones, it indicates a network portion. Here, 255, it indicates a network portion. So now, this is called as a default mask. So now we will move to the class C network and we'll see how to subnet the class C network. So to subnet the class C network, first you should have in your mind how many subnet does the subnet mask produce. For example, if I use particular mask, subnet mask, then it should match my requirement. For example, I have ISP has given me particular block of IP address 192.16.0.0. Particular block of IP address is given by the ISP. I want to divide that block to satisfy the requirements of 8 branches of my organization, which are located in different geographical place. So that you have to see how many valid host per subnet. So the second question, what are the valid subnets? What are the broadcast address? What are the valid host? All these questions should be answered. So one by one. So for that, we'll move first. So dear friends, here you see one simple example, subnetting. So for this one, I will try to explain this one with the help of. So here, my dear students. So we will take the IP address. It is 192.168. I am using private address for explanation. 5.x x, or 5.2. This is the address from the block of address given by the IP, from the block of address given by the ISP. Or here you just see the network address, which is the network address here. Or this is actually address of the entire machine. Now, what is the network address? So to find out the network address, we have to use the default subnet mask. Default subnet mask is 255.255.0. So now you have to convert this both to binary. 255 means 8 ones, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And your computer will do logical ANDing function. When it do the logical ANDing function, you know, when you do the logical AND with 1, you will get the same number, right? Here also you will get the same number, right? Here also you will get the same number, right? But here you will get 0. So this indicates the network address. So to subnet this network, how many hosts is possible here in this network? 254 hosts is possible. In this network, 254 hosts is possible. This network, 254 hosts is possible. But I have 6 branches. Like I will take branch X, branch Y, branch Z, branch A, branch B, branch C, 6 branches. And each branch capacity is 30. 30 computers are there. So total how many computers according to you? 180. So here I can take, instead of taking separate, see here, if I take this address for X, I can take one more network address, 192.168.6.0, and I can take it for Y. Like this, you can take 7.0, 8.0, but what is the requirement? 30. But what is the capacity here? 254. Means how many hosts you are approximately wasting? 220. So 220 into 60 means 1000 or 1200 address you are wasting. So instead of that one, this address I am taking, this only this network I am taking, I am dividing this network into 6 subnet. So dividing this network into 6 subnet. So that is called as subnetting. So we'll see now how to do this one. So address given is 192.168.168.5.0 network address. Host address is 192.168.5.1. Now my requirement is 6 branches. I have 6 branches. That means I need 6 subnet, and each branch 30 computers are there. So now this is the default. This is the default, right? What is the mask here? Default mask 255. Now if you want to create subnet, you should not touch this default mask. Here you know 8 bits are available for host 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 bits are available for host. This bit you have to take from left and you have to convert into subnet. That means you can take this bit, I will call that S subnet, or you can take 2 bits subnet. You can take 3 bits for subnets. You can take 4 bits for subnet. You can take 5 bits for subnets. You can take 6 bits for subnets. You can take 7 bits for subnets. You cannot take 8 bits, because if you use all bits for subnet, then you cannot allocate for host. If you take 1 bit for subnet here, how many bits are left for host? 7. Understood? 1 bit for subnet. So what is the value of this one? Positional value of this one. You know positional value, right? Positional value is something like MSB's positional value is 128, then 64, then 32, then 16, then 8, then 4, then 2, then 1. So this value is 128. That means here mask is, I will write the entire mask now here. I will write the entire mask 255.255.128, or Cisco's representation is /25. 25 means default is 24. Here it is 8 plus 8 plus 8. This is default is 24. One extra bit is used, that is 25. /25. 25 bits are used for subnet working. Sorry, 1 bit is used for subnetting. And this is the masks. Under this mask, where 2 subnets are available. If you use 1 bit, what is the possibility? Either 0 or 128. 2 possibility, right? 2 subnets are available. If you use 1 bit, 2 subnets are available. How to find out this one? You have one more formula. 2 raised to power 1 is equal to 0. 2 raised to power 1 is equal to 2. How many hosts are possible? 7 bit, alwa. 2 raised to power 7 minus 2. That is, you will get 126 host is possible here. Is it clear? Yes. The second one, you see here. What is the positional value? Positional value is 128 and 64, 192. So this position, 192, rest same. I will not write because this pen is not so comfortable. So I am not writing that one. So rest of the bits are same here, 192. So 2 bits are you using? That means 2 raised to power 2. How many subnets are possible? 4 subnets are possible. How many host is possible here? 2 raised to power 6 minus 2. That is 2 raised to 6 is equal to 64 and minus 2 is 62 host is possible. So like that you can find out various this one. So here Cisco you refer this by 26. 26 means what? 24 bits are used default, 2 bits are used for subnetting. When you use 2 bits, then you will get 4 subnet. Each subnet capacity is 62 host. So, we'll see my friends, what is our requirement? I want 6 subnets, but I want this one. Each subnet should handle 30 host also. So, if I take 2 bits, is it possible 6 subnets? 2 raised to power 2 is equal to 4. If I take 3 bits, 2 raised to power 3 is equal to 8. This is 2 raised to power 2 is equal to 4. So somehow I cannot go for this one. I have to compromise with this one. So 2 raised to power 3 is equal to 8. That means, my dear friends, I have to take, in my case here, 6 subnets. This is the mask. So what is the value of this mask? 224. This is the value of this mask. 224. That is 255.255.255.224. That is the mask. Now, after that, how many bits are allotted for host? 5 bits are allotted. 2 raised to power 5 minus 2. That gives you 30. So, it is going to meet my requirement. So, I will use this one. This is the mask I will use. So, how to subnet this one now? How to subnet this one? Let me explain this one one by one. Then we'll go to the once again book. First, you will take the address 192.168.168.5.0. You have to subnet this one. So it is given 27. 27 means 24 is default. 3 bits, extra bits are used. 24 is default. 3 extra bits I am taking from the host position and I convert into subnet. This is 27. And this is in Cisco representation. What do you call prefix? So you have to write in other way 255. Just now I explained you this one. 255 and next one is 224. This is my mask. Now, how many host possible? For that, you use the formula 2 raised to power h. Sorry, 2 raised to power n. How many subnet possible? 2 raised to power s. So that is, how many bits I am using here? 3 bits I am using. 3 bits. 1, 2, 3. And rest of the bits, 5 bits I am using for host. That we saw in the last example. So 2 raised to power 3, 2 raised to power 3 is equal to 8. This is the number of subnet possible. My requirement according to my problem statement 6. No problem. 2 so extra subnet I will get, that I can either use it or I can, it, you can think it is a waste or you can use it as it is. So how many host is possible? 2 raised to power h. 2 raised to power h is equal to value 2 and what is that? 5 bits and minus 2. This is the formula. Minus 2. You may ask why it is minus 2. See, when you take any address, first combination and last combination, I am not taking. Last combination is all ones and first combination all zeros. So that cannot be assigned to the machine. So this is around 30. Then what is the first subnet? What is the first subnet? First subnet is always 0. What is the, how to find out the subnets? There is a formula, 256 minus mask. So now, mask means you need not to take entire last digit, last this one only you have to take 224. 256 minus 224, that is gives you 32. So first subnet is 32, first subnet is 0, second subnet is 32 and multiplication. Third subnet is 32 1s are 32, 32 2s are 64, don't double it directly, 32 3s are 96, 32 4s are 128, it will proceed like this. So I will draw one table here. So this is the table. So this is the subnet and this is first host, last host and broadcast in that subnet. So you see here, 0, here 32 means here, easily you can write 31, here 31 means here 30, here first host means 1, here 64 means here you can write 63, here you can write 62, here you can write 32, right? 33, sorry. So in this way, how many subnets possible you can proceed. See, this is 0 subnet, including 0, it is 8. So I can say 0, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th. So 8 subnets are possible. Now, whether you need to draw the entire table or you can you stop somewhere, for this question you have to write like this and you have to say dot, 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 dot. It proceeds like this. Suppose if I give the IP address 24 and if I ask you to find the subnet for this one, then you can see 24 comes somewhere here, right? Somewhere here. So what is the subnet? Subnet is 192, 168, 0 dot, sorry, I'm sorry, 5 dot 0, this is a subnet address, slash 27, that is important, mask is important. Then in that, first host is 1, you have to write entire address, last host is 30 and broadcast is 31. Suppose if I ask here 42, then subnet is this one. If I ask 99, subnet is this one. In that subnet, what is the first host, what is the last host, what is the broadcast, all these things you have to see. In this way, you have to solve the problem, my dear students. So, now we will proceed to solve some of the problems. I have already explained. Now I will give some simple clues so that we can see how this works.